tree is again the primitive family, and which have just some characteristic which are matching with the Bentham and Hooker's classification. It falls under the division Phanerogamia, class Dicotyledoni, subclass Polypetali, series Thalamiflora, order Ranales, and family Nymphaeaceae. As you have seen, this flower at the right side, you might have been seen this flower. This is the lotus flower. So this can be considered as a family, lotus family. There are some common plants which may be found everywhere in India or nearby countries. So you can see here the flower and fruit of that particular member. That is Nilambo speciosum. It is called the Indian lotus and cultivated in most of the lake for its rhizome as well as for the flower for worshipping the god. Then the second flower, see again the beautiful flower. It is Nilambo nucifera, slightly purple in color. Rose or purple colored flowers are there, and it is also used as a sacred lotus of the Hindus. Sacred lotus means that आपण पूजेसाठी वापरतो. तर त्या लोटसला पूजेसाठी वापरणारे लोटसला आपण sacred lotus असं म्हटलेलं आहे. So it is the Nilambo nucifera, commonly used for the worshipping god. This is a yellow lotus. It is Nuphar luteum. It is commonly known as yellow water lily. Not found in commonly in India, but in other countries it is very common. This is quite interesting that Victoria regia, it is known as the giant water lily, a native of South America. See the leaf structure of this particular lily. Flowers are there, white flowers, smaller, small in size, but the leaves are so large, so that these are the two kids which are sit on the leaf itself. So you can just imagine that it is at the radius of 90 to 150 centimeters broad and floating with the leaves. So margins are slightly upcurved. Normally it is not found in other members, but here in Victoria regia you can find this is the just plate like structure. Now see the these two kids which are seated there. At least the age, particularly weight of one kid, it is around 25 to 30 kg. So itself, it may not be that much, but we can say it is around 20 kg. And two kids of 20 kg means we can say that the itself leaf can bear the weight of around 35 to 40 kg on the surface of leaf. So it is the largest leaf we can find in this family. The another member is the Uriel ferox. Leaves are floating, but the characteristic feature of these particular leaves is these are having a spinescent nature. Normally in other lilies it is not, it is just a plain surface, glaucous surface is there, but in this member we can find that there is a leaf surface as well as on the perianth region, petiole, that pedicel region, we can find the densely covered with the prickles. These are small spines. So it is one of the basic character of this member, Uriel ferox. When we talk about the habit and habitat along with the distribution of this species, habit, as you know, these are aquatic plants, aquatic herbs, either annual or perennial, with colored and watery latex. The stem or the petiole bears the latex in that. So flowers, it is just a get together of flowers of the various colors. It is not naturally found likewise. It is just a photograph structure. But we can find that a variety of color has been noticed in this family, particularly in genus Nymphaea and Nilambo. And it is mostly aquatic, predominantly aquatic, or in the marshy places it can grow well. It is commonly called a water lily, or the family itself called the water lily family. It consists about 8 genera and 100 species according to the Rendell. It is almost a cosmopolitan in distribution, except in the very cold region. म्हणजे जिथं कायम बर्फ आहे असा जर एखादा परिसर सोडला तर बाकी सर्व ठिकाणी जवळपास आपल्याला निलंबो निसिफेरा हा जगभरात पसरलेला दिसतो. देर आर सम कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक एज युजल रूट स्टेम अँड लिव्ह व्हेजिटेटिव्ह प्लांट पार्ट्स ऑफ द दॅट पर्टिक्युलर फॅमिली मेंबर्स. हियर यू कॅन फाइंड ॲट द प्लांट्स आर ॲक्वॅटिक. दे हॅव द टिपिकल रूट स्ट्रक्चर और द पेट्युलर स्ट्रक्चर वेअर दीज एअर कॅव्हिटीज आर प्रॉमिनेंटली ऑब्झर्व. हियर यू कॅन फाइंड दीज आर द ऍक्च्युली रूट्स ऑफ और राइझोम्स ऑफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर फॅमिली मेंबर निम्फेसी. इट इज फ्रॉम द निलंबो. सो हियर दीज आर इडिबल राइझोम्स. सो राइझोम्स कॅन बी इटन एज अ वेजिटेबल. सो दीज आर स्लेंडर अँड अटॅच टू द रूट स्टॉक. दिस राइझोम इज मोस्टली हॅविंग द एअर कॅव्हिटीज इन दॅट अँड दिस कॅन बी लुक लाईक अ सिलेंडर, स्मॉलर सिलेंडर्स लाईक दॅट. द स्टेम इज अगेन राइझोम. जस्ट लाईक इन द जिंजर वी कॅन फाइंड देर इज द कनेक्टिव्हिटी बिटवीन दीज टू राइझोम्स अँड रूटेड इन द मड ऑर एट द बॉटम ऑफ द शॅलो लेक और पॉन्ड्स वी कॅन से दॅट. दीज आर ब्रांच्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स इरेक्ट और क्रिपिंग इन निम्फिया. क्रिपिंग मीन्स दे आर गोइंग हरिझेंटली, डेव्हलपिंग हरिझेंटली इन दॅट. सो सच टाइप ऑफ द स्टेम इज देअर. स्टेम इज ऑल्सो डेलिकेट अँड इट इज मोस्टली सबमर्ज इन द वॉटर. लीव्स आर टिपिकल. यू जस्ट यू कॅन सी द लीफ ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर निम्फिया इज देअर. सो हियर अ वॉटर ड्रॉपलेट इज शोन ऑन दॅट. सो इट इज द हायड्रोफोबिक टाइप ऑफ द लीफ वेअर वॉटर इज नॉट अ स्टे ऑन द लीफ सर्फेस. इट इज ॲक्च्युली द नीड ऑफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर स्पीसीज बिकॉज दे आर ग्रोईंग इन द दॅट पर्टिक्युलर टाईप ऑफ द लीफ लेक अँड बिकॉज ऑफ दॅट वी फाईंड दे आर लिव्हिंग इन द वॉटर अँड दे नीड टू बी सेफ सेफ टू लिव्ह फ्रॉम द वॉटर अँड दॅट्स वाय दीज लीव्स आर स्लाइटली ग्लाउकस इन नेचर हॅविंग द वॅक्सी कोट ऑन द सर्फेस. दीज आर अल्टरनेट सिंपल. इट इज लॉन्ग पिट्यूल्ड and floating or slightly immersed in the water. These are normally large, broad, with broad lamina. Sometimes dimorphic. Dimorphic means where you can find two types of leaves. Submerged leaves are of a different structure and the floating or standing leaves are of different nature. So in Kabomba, we find such type of the leaves where leaf dimorphism you can easily observe. The leaves of Victoria regia, we just have seen that plate-like leaves. The royal water lily of South America, having about 60 to 180 centimeters in diameter, and with it is the upturned margins, just like a plate. So, and they might be having the spines at the lower surface. On the dorsal surface, they are prickly. So, such type of the leaves are normally found. So that from underside, no organism can damage the leaves. When we talk about the reproductive structures or the floral structures, we can find that the inflorescence is normally solitary because most of the times you find all the lilies, particularly from this family Nymphaeaceae, they are a single solitary, terminally or axillary, on the long leafless scapes. We always find a pedicel which is a commonly long and that scape is there and they doesn't have any leaves on that. So these are normally the solitary single flowers. These flowers are large, beautifully pigmented. They are color showy, mostly bisexual flowers, hermaphrodite flowers, and the condition is hypogynous to perigynous. It is acyclic in nature and rarely we find the cyclic thalamus. Normally thalamus is fleshy and embeds the seeds inside. It is normally a half cut cup like structure and surrounded the carpels, or sometimes the carpels are embedded in that. So with perianth and stamens, they are adnated and the flowers are mostly fragrant. So all these are the general character of the flowers. There is no such calyx which are normally green in color, but here you can find there is the slight differentiation in that. Normally sepals are three, as usual in Brassinia there are three sepals. In most of the species we find it is the six to indefinite, because this family, as this is the aquatic family, you can easily transformation from the sepal to the endocoel conditions. So the coloration of the perianth may appear in some species, and there is the gradual transformation from calyx to corolla is easily observed in these members. So 6 to indefinite number of the calyx is there. They are normally free, and gradual transition from sepals to petal is taken place in this family. The petals to stamen is also the gradual transition you can be easily observed in these members. Corollas normally 3 petals, 3 to 5, or sometimes many. It may be indefinite, we can say that. They are polypetalous, they are free, large and attractive, and the inner petals from petaloid staminodia. Now, what these terms indicate that? Because just I said that there is a clear-cut transformation you can observe in this family or in the flower. From calyx to androecium, there is the gradual differentiation, gradual modification in the leaves, so that in normal flower we can find that calyx is different, corolla is different, at the same time androecium is different. But in this nymphaeaceae member, you can find the gradual transformation. Je jeva apan matlela hai ki vegetative shoot is modified into reproductive shoots, तर याचं ट्रान्सफॉर्मेशन आपल्याला ह्या ग्रुपमध्ये बघायला मिळतं. ठीक आहे, ते आपण नंतर बघणारच आहोत. देन अँड्रोशियम अँड गायनेशियम इन दिस मेंबर फ्लावर. अँड्रोशियम्स आर नॉर्मली वी कॅन टॉक अबाउट द फर्टाईल अँड्रोशियम नाव, बिकॉज स्टॅमिनोड्स आर ऑल्सो देअर इन दिस मेंबर. स्टेमन्स आर 6 टू इनडेफिनेट, दे आर फ्री, ऍडनेट टू द थॅलॅमस, दे आर अटॅच टू द थॅलॅमस, अँड दे आर नॉर्मली स्पायरली अरेंज्ड. So, spirally arranged, anthers are normally bithecous, two anther cells are there, and they are dehiscing on the towards the gynoecium, and that's why they are called the introns androecium or the anthers. The filaments are normally the foliaceous. Now, these filaments are just like a leaf-like or the petal-like structures, and that's why we call them as a foliaceous or leaf-like filament. It is extended as a sterile appendages beyond the anther sac. It is, we can say broadly, it is the connective-like structure, foliaceous connective-like structure of filament. Filament as such, there is very short. Then gynoecium, it is basically three number is there, tricarpellary, or it can be the multicarpellary. They are apocarpous, they are always free. Two families have been shown here, that is the camboboidae and nilamboidae. So in these members, three to ovaries are apocarpous. In some members of this family, there is the syncarpous condition like the nymphoidae. Then ovaries are normally superior, but in some members like the Victoria, we find the inferior ovary. They are normally unilocular to multilocular. If one ovary is there, or one gynoecium is there, unilocular condition is there, and when it is the fused condition, it is the naturally the multilocular condition you can observe here in the family. Then stigmas, as many as carpels, there ek gynoecium asel, the ek stigma asel, bicarpellary syncarpous ovary asel, the don stigma asel. So number of carpels and the number of stigma is just as many as the condition. Then they are free or united and radiating often with the appendages. So appendage, or we can say that the connective, is extended here, and because of that it can be shown like that. The fruit is a spongy berry. in Nymphaea and Icario of Achaeans in Nilambo. Okay? It is also a follicle-like fruit which is found in the Camboba. So such type of the variations in the fruit structure is also there. Spongy, berry-like, Icario of Achaean in Nilambo and in follicle in the Camboba. So these three types of the variations can be observed in the fruit type also. Here you can observe at the left side, these are hole-like structures where there is seed is developed, and this is, we can say, the actually the fruit-like structure. So seeds are often aerulate, endospermic or non-endospermic, and embryo is normally straight. The perisperm is also present there. Pollination is normally entamophilous, flowers, they are protogynous, and they are mostly cleistogamous for the self-pollinated conditions. आता एक गोष्ट लक्षात घ्या की तुम्हाला पारंपरिक पद्धतीने एक उदाहरण सांगितलं जात होतं किंवा आपण ते ऐकलेलं आहे की एक भुंगा जो असतो तो संध्याकाळच्या वेळेस त्या फुलाला व्हिजिट करायला जातो टू कलेक्ट द नेक्टर, अँड ग्रॅज्युअली जशी संध्याकाळ होते तो कमळ जो आहे तो आपल्या पाकळ्या मिटून घेतो आणि तो भुंगा मधल्यामध्ये अडकतो. सो दिस इज द रुटीन प्रॅक्टिस इन दिस मेंबर्स, कारण भुंगे त्याच्यामध्ये अडकलेलेच असतात, अँड ग्रॅज्युअली यू कॅन फाइंड दिस एंटेमोफिलस पॉलिनेशन त्याच्यामध्ये. कसं आहे, भुंगा अडकल्यानंतर तो तिथल्या तिथे फिरत राहणार आहे. नॅचरली इट्स हिज लेग कॅन अटॅच सम पोलन ग्रेन्स, अँड वी फाइंड इन द सेम फ्लावर देअर इज द gynoecium, and because of that on this flat gynoecium they move, just like because of the attachment of pollen grains on their legs they can fall down on the stigmas of the flower and they can be self pollinated. So it is the cleistogamous condition, and we can find the self pollination is also observed in the urine like generals. When we talk about the floral formula kay sangto, flower is actinomorphic. Here you can find that sign, actinomorphic, calyx 3 to 5 or indefinite number is not fixed, because we are not talking about the single flower or the single genera, it is for the whole family. So the floral formula also shows such type of the broad scope of the writing. So flowers are mostly actinomorphic, bisexual, calyx 3 to indefinite, corolla 3 to indefinite, androecium 3 to indefinite, and gynoecium sudha 3 to indefinite. Androecium, gynoecium are the free. So such type of the condition can be written in the floral formula also. So to learning such type of the structures is very easy. Here you can find the technical diagram of this particular members. One is from the Nymphaea blaine and another one is the Nymphaea alba. Here you can find the complete structure. Now in complete structure they are attached with the rhizomatic leaves. Normally this petiole is long and most of the times they are hollow. Here you can see after cutting there is the parenchyma is present inside. These are the leaves. Such type of the leaves also known as the sagittate type of the leaves. So these leaves on the lower surface you can find the clear cut venation, and on the upper surface these are mostly glossy, so that waxy coating is there. Lower surface in most of the members they are having the spinescent or the prickly nature texture of the lower surface. Now in this lower surface we find that these smaller spines will protect from the we can say the watery organisms, maybe fishes or some insect, those are growing there. So for protection purpose the dorsal side of the leaf is always, most of the times it is prickly. When we shift to the inflorescence, it's a ekas scape dakhavlela aahe doni condition madhe tumhi baghu shakta. It is a long scape, and this long scape itself indicate that it is the leafless scape having the pedicel is long, and it is also having the parenchymatous nature inside. So such type of the variations can observe here. Then second one is the corolla and the inflorescence structure. Flowers are mostly solitary. And arrangement of the petals and sepals you can see here. And normally there are three sepals. Here you can find one, two, three sepals. These sepals are protecting the petaloid conditions in the bud condition. When we go a little inside, you can find that these are all petals. Petals are just, we call that 3 to indefinite number of the petal is there. And inside that, these are all free androecial conditions. Here also the same condition is there. And at the center, we can find the thalamus. On thalamus, there is the gynecium. Here you can find the clear-cut structure of that. This is the ovary. Now, this ovary, this thalamus portion, and on that, these are the gynoecium's present, and all these are stamens. If you see carefully, the inner layer of these androecium's are showing the actual androecial conditions. Here you can find the two types of the androecium's. This is the one structure, and this is the second one. Just we have discussed that it is the transformation can be shown in these members. So how it transforms, here you can observe that. Here you can find this is the petal. This is the long petal. The petal size is reduced at this level. This is larger petal. This is smaller than that. And inside we can find the androecium is there. Now this androecium are of two different types. See here, or you can see here. Now here there is the transformation. There is a transformation from petal to the androecial conditions. The petal madhe kay hai? Petal la kutehi asa anther sarke structure asnar nahi. These are the petals. Yacha madhe aahe ka kuthe anther chikadleli nahi. Naturally, at this step, anther cells are going to be developed. Ata anther cells develop zhale mhanje tyachyat anther develop zhale asa aahe ka? Nahi. These are just the pockets. These are empty pockets. And because of that, though they are looking like the anther cell, but doesn't have the pollen grains. And all such type of the structures are called now as the staminodes. These are the petaloid staminodes. And these transitions can be observed in the nymphaea members. So here you can observe these structures. So the innermost structure is actually the androecium-like structure. And in between that, petals and androecium, such type of the staminodes are there. And inside that, there is the such type of the thalamus bearing the ovaries. All these structures are the spirally arranged. Okay. When we talk about the fruit, fruit is developed like this. This is the actually stigmatic portion, and all the gynoecium are there after fertilization. When we take the TS of this ovary, you can find the multilocular ovules are present. These are multilocular condition which is found in the nymphaea. So you might have been understand all those structures. The calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Sagle structure apan ithe tela ek well diagram cha madhyamatun tumhala dakhavnyacha prayatna kelela. Theek aahe? The other important character of this family. Here you can find that physiologically and biochemistry wise, there are some chemicals present or absent in every family, and this can become the characteristic of this family. So here in family Nymphaeaceae, these are non-cynogenic, though cynogenic compounds are not found in this family, but alkaloids are present. They may be absent, but in most of the members, alkaloids present. Iridoids are not detected, and proanthocyanins are present. Then flavonoids are present, flavonols or flavononols, flavonoids. So these all conditions are found in the such type of the family members. Then absent in Nymphaea, it is the kimferol and quercetin or myrisetins were present. Ellagic acid is present in Nymphaea, or it may be absent in the Nymphaea Capensis or Nymphaea lutea. So some chemicals are present, some chemicals are absent. So that can be the character of that particular genera. Then aluminium accumulation is not found. Because most of the chemical industries, they leave their chemical waste inside the water bodies in most of the cases. And there are some aluminum oxides which may be dangerous for the common flora and fauna of that region. So we use remediation methods, and we can put some plants which are having the capacity to absorb certain of the molecules. So here, accumulation of aluminium in this particular nymphaea member or the nymphaeaceae members is not observed, and because of that, chemists we can suggest such type of the environmental issues where we can find the chemical waste is put into the water bodies. So there is no suggestion where it can be the aluminium accumulation is there. So there is no suggestion is given so that plantation of nymphaea in such type of the water bodies is not done in these areas. Saponins and saponogenins were absent. Saponins are particularly fish poisoning agents, so these are not found in these members. Then, what is the economic importance of the family? As we yesterday also discussed, medicinal for food purpose, ornamental purposes, or for the timber purposes. So, many family members are being used for such different purposes. Here you can find that the members of Nilembu nucifera are recommended as the cardiac tonic and also the treatment of liver diseases. What is the use? The flower of Nilembu nucifera. वरच जे फ्लावर आहे, गुलाबी रंगाचं जे कमळाचं फूल आहे, सो हिअर यू कॅन फाइंड दॅट इट इज यूज एज अ कार्डियक टॉनिक, म्हणजे हार्ट साठी ते टॉनिक म्हणून काम करतं. ऑल्सो इन ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ लिव्हर डिसीजेस, ज्याचं लिव्हर डॅमेज झालेलं आहे त्याच्यासाठी सुद्धा कमळाच्या फुलाचा उपयोग होऊ शकतो. द ड्राईड अँड पावडर्ड रायझोम्स ऑफ निलंबो निसिफेरा आर यूज टू क्युअर पाइल्स, म्हणजे पाइल्स नथिंग बट त्याला काय म्हणतो आपण, फिशर्स फिशर्स किंवा मूळ व्याधी जे ज्यांना असतंय, तर त्यांच्यासाठी ड्राईड अँड पावडर्ड रायझोम्स, म्हणजे त्या कंदाची पावडर जी केलेली असते ती पावडर त्यांना खायला दिली. इट कॅन क्युअर द पाइल्स. द रायझोम्स ऑफ निम्फिया लोटस आर यूज इन द डिसेंट्री, म्हणजे थोडक्यात जर आपण त्याच्या रायझोमची भाजी खाल्ली, त्याच्या कंदांची भाजी खाल्ली, तर पोटाशी संबंधित असलेले विकार, दिस पाइल्स आर एट द एंड अँड डिसेंट्री इज ड्यू टू द इनडायजेशन, तर पोटाशी असलेले विकार त्या रायझोम पासून तुम्हाला तिची मुक्ती मिळू शकते. सो दीज मेंबर्स आर द मेडिसिनल मेंबर्स. एज मोस्ट ऑफ द मेंबर्स आर हॅव्हिंग द ब्युटिफुल फ्लावर्स, दे कॅन बी प्लांटेड इन द गार्डन्स, दॅट्स वाय इट हॅज द ऑर्नामेंटल व्हॅल्यू. बरोबर आहे, दे कॅन बी कल्टिवेटेड or planted in the gardens. It is also used as a food. Actually, these are the seeds. These seeds of the Nymphaea nilambium are edible due to stored starch. हे जे सीड्स आहेत, जसं मक्याचे दाणे असतात, मक्याच्या दाण्यापासून आपण काय तयार करतो, इट इज द पॉपकॉर्न. सो हियर वी कॅन फाइंड द पॉप स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दीज सीड्स, म्हणजे जसं पॉपकॉर्न आपण कॉर्नच्या सीडचा करतो, तर तसंच दीज आर द पॉप लोटस सीड्स. लोटस सीड्स पासून सुद्धा असे पॉप बॉल्स तयार होतात बिकॉज इट इज हॅव्हिंग द स्टार्च इन साइड, आणि तो स्टोर्ड स्टार्च असल्यामुळे नॅचरली हिअर यू कॅन फाइंड द पॉप बॉल लाईक स्ट्रक्चर्स, ऑर द काय म्हणून पॉप्ड सीड्स कॅन बी इटन. द सेकंड इज द रायझोम्स ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर स्ट्रक्चर, रायझोम्स ऑफ निलंबू पेंटाफायला. नॉर्मली दे आर यूज एज अ व्हेजिटेबल, त्याचे मेडिसिनल युजेस आपण जस्ट मी तुम्हाला सांगितलेले आहेत. सो लाईक वाईज यू कॅन ऑल्सो फाइंड द व्हेरायटी ऑफ द मेडिसिनल युजेस फॉर फूड पर्पजेस, ऑर इट कॅन बी यूज इन द गार्डन्स ऑल्सो. नाउ हियर यू कॅन डिस्कस द अफिनिटी ऑफ दिस ग्रुप. जस्ट इन फॅमिली मॅग्नोलियाशी वी डिस्कस दॅट द फॅमिली इज मोस्टली हॅव्हिंग द क्लोज अफिनिटी विथ द फॅमिली अनोनेसी. हिअर ऑल्सो दिस मॅग्नोलियसी जस्ट मिनिट दिस निम्फिएसी हॅज द अफिनिटी with family Ranunculaceae. Now, Ranunculaceae has affinity with Nymphaeaceae, though it is the particularly through the family, subfamily Giardiaceae, Cambovidae. Cambovidae is the in-between family where Nymphaea and Ranunculaceae can be connected via this Cambovidae members. It is having the apocarpous pistil and spiral arrangement of the floral parts, and Nymphaeaceae resembles the Berberidaceae in arillate seeds manje jyacha madhe thodasa starch content ahe, edible seeds. So these are also found in this member. The structure of the ovary is and aquatic habit of the plant is similar in the Nymphaeaceae and Alismaceae. Alismaceae is also the hydrophytic family. So Alismaceae, Berberidaceae and Nymphaeaceae having the affinities in between. The Cronquist in 1967 suggested that Nymphaeaceae as the probable ancestor of monocots because of the following characters. त्याच्यामध्ये कुठले कॅरेक्टर आहेत की जे सिमिलरिटी दर्शवतात अँड द ओरिजिन ऑफ द मोनोकॉट कॅन बी प्रूव्ड विथ दीज कॅरेक्टर्स बिकॉज दे आर हॅव्हिंग द अक्वॅटिक हॅबिट देर इज लॅक ऑफ वेसल्स ऍबसेन्स ऑफ कॅम्बियम इन वेस्क्युलर बंडल्स लॅमिनर प्लासेंटेशन अँड हॅव्हिंग द पेरियंथ सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द कॉमन कॅरेक्टर विच कॅन बी फाउंड इन द मोनोकॉट्स ऑल्सो अँड एज वेल एज इन दिस ग्रुप ऑल्सो. Then what are the primitive characters? Because it should be connected with the primitive monocotyledons. So what are the primitive characters for that? Nymphaeaceae is a primitive family under herbaceous ranales. It is having the solitary or terminally inflorescence. Flowers are large and bisexual. They are actinomorphic. They are normally spirally arranged. Thalamus is present. And their ovaries may be free or fused in some cases. Stamens are having the lamina like structures, primitive structure, and they are numerous. Polycarpellary and apocarpous ovaries are also observed in these members, and seeds are large and endospermic. Then what are the advanced characters for that? These are the primitive characters. Advanced character, they are having the herbaceous habit. Herbaceous habit itself indicate that they are the advanced than the dicotyledons. Okay. The sepals and petals, three in each sum. Normally, sagle monocot member je ahet, they are having the tricarpellary syncarpous ovary and the perianth whorls are also in terms of the three multiplied condition in the three. So, perigynous and epigynous condition of the flower is also is the advanced character in the family Nymphaeaceae. The syncarpous gynecium in Nymphaea and in Nuphar you also find that is also the syncarpy is also advanced character. The fruit is iterio of achenes in Nilambo. It also indicates it is the advanced group. So this is about the affinity of that particular group.